Good evening. Welcome to St. Joe's. Though the thunderstorm has passed, we rejoice in the brightness of God as we rise and sing our entrance hymn, number 577 in our gray hymnal, To God with Gladness Sing, hymn 577. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The Lord be with you. Brothers and sisters, let us call to mind our sins, and so prepare ourselves to celebrate these sacred mysteries. You were sent to heal the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy. You came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy. You are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us. Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Manifest your almighty power, above all by pardoning and showing mercy. Bestow, we pray, your grace abundantly upon us, and make those hastening to attain your promises heirs to the treasures of heaven. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever. Amen. Let us be seated for the readings.
reading from the book of the prophet Ezekiel. Thus says the Lord, you say the Lord's way is not fair. Hear now, house of Israel, is it my way that is unfair? Or rather, are not your ways unfair? When someone virtuous turns away from virtue to commit iniquity and dies, it is because of the iniquity he committed that he must die. But if he turns from the wickedness he has committed and does what is right and just, he shall preserve his life, since he has turned away from all the sins that he has committed. He shall surely live. He shall not die. The word of the Lord. Remember your mercies, O Lord. Your ways, O Lord, make known to me. Teach me your paths. Guide me in your truth and teach me, for you are God, my Savior. Remember that your compassion, O Lord, and your love are from of old. The sins of my youth and my frailties, remember not. In your kindness, remember me. Good and upright is the Lord. Thus he shows sinners the way. He guides the humble to justice and teaches the humble his way. A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Philippians. Brothers and sisters, if there is any encouragement in Christ, any solace in love, any participation in the Spirit, any compassion and mercy, complete my joy by being of the same mind, with the same love, united in heart, thinking one thing. Do nothing out of selfishness or out of vainglory. Rather, humbly regard others as more important than yourselves, each looking out not for his own interest, but also for those of others. Have in you the same attitude that is also in Christ Jesus, who, though he was in the form of God, did not regard equality with God something to be grasped. Rather, he emptied himself, taking the form of a slave, coming in human likeness, and found human in appearance. He humbled himself, becoming obedient to the point of death, even death on a cross. Because of this, God greatly exalted him and bestowed on him the name which is above every name, that at the name of Jesus, every knee should bend, of those in heaven and on earth and under the earth, and every tongue confess that Jesus Christ is Lord, to the glory of God the Father. The word of the Lord.
The Lord be with you.
And with
a reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus said to the chief priests and the elders of the people, "What is your opinion? A man had two sons. He came to the first and said, 'Son, go out and work in the vineyard today.' He said in reply, 'I will not.' But afterwards, changed his mind and went. The man came to the other son and gave the same order. He said in reply, 'Yes, sir,' but did not go. Which of the two did his father's will?" They answered, "The first." Jesus said, "Amen, I say to you, tax collectors and prostitutes are entering the kingdom of God before you. When John came to you in the way of righteousness, you did not believe him. But tax collectors and prostitutes did. Yet even when you saw that, you did not later change your minds and believe him." The Gospel of the Lord. Good evening. With tonight's reading, we have entered into a Holy Week of sorts. If we look at where we are in the Gospel of Matthew, Jesus and his disciples are entering into the Holy City. And in these next few weeks, as we work our way to the end of the liturgical year, the great solemnity of Christ the King in November, we'll see that we will be working our way through this, our Lord's last week on earth, leading up to his great passion and death. This is a very powerful set of readings we have coming up in the weeks ahead. So may we always keep our hearts and our ears open to the powerful words of Christ. But today, we see a very poignant example of a man with two sons. and the importance of having your words and your actions match up, because in our parable, they simply don't. The first son is asked to go work in the vineyard, and he said, "I will not. Dad, I've got better things to do. I've got a whole bunch of other things on my plate right now. I don't have time to do your work. I've got to do these other things." Well, perhaps his other work got done early. Perhaps it was a little bit of guilt. Perhaps it was a great memory of all the sacrifice that Dad did for him. Either way, eventually his butt showed up at the vineyard. He offered his labor to the father. Now the second, when approached by Dad and asked to head on out to the vineyard, is incredibly agreeable. "Of course, sir. Yes, sir. I will go, sir, right away, sir. Whatever you say, sir." And did not. Now we don't know his heart. You know, maybe he meant to and simply got distracted or forgot. I mean, how many of us, you know, have been asked by our spouse, you know, "Dear, could you pick up some milk and bread on your way home from work?" And we show up home empty-handed. Not intentionally, but just due to the busyness of life, we just plain forgot. Or maybe it was malicious. Slacker, tell Dad what he wants to know. He doesn't check up, he won't know. I can do what I want. Dad's not here all the time. He'll never find out. And sometimes we can even live our lives like that. We feel like if we offer a prayer here or there, or if we, you know, go to church on Sunday, well then the other 6 days of the week are for us. But when it comes to living a Christian life, it's not about living just a little bit. But to love the Lord is something that necessitates the whole heart. Just as Jesus embraced the cross, not a little bit, but completely, entirely, and totally, permitting not only the nails to pierce his hands and feet, permitting not only the crown to grace his head as those thorns poke through, not only permitting himself to be mocked and ridiculed, stripped naked for all the world to see, and then to breathe his last breath, and to permit his sacred body to be profaned with the spear piercing his side. Jesus gave of himself completely and totally. There was no duplicity in him. He gave all for us. And so, my dear friends, we must ask ourselves, which son are we? The one who remembers the love of his father, and though at times we may resist his love, we find ourselves working in the vineyard? Or are we the other one that says, "Oh, sure, Dad, I'll do it," but never does? Now, ideally, would be the best of both and say to the Lord, "Yes, Lord, I will serve," and go and do it. And may that be our prayer in this week ahead. Lord, help me to see the invitations to serve in your vineyard. Help me to see how it is that you are calling me to share your love in this world. How is it that you want me to use that unique set of gifts and talents that you have bestowed upon my heart and to use those gifts to magnify your love? we have the courage to ask those questions, then perhaps when the Lord asks us to serve, we may indeed be that joyful servant going forth and doing the Father's will. May God bless you always. My dear brothers and sisters, we rise in prayer as we proclaim what we believe. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made, for us men and for our salvation. He came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary, and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day, in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, with the Father and the Son, is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and life of the world to come. Amen. Thankful for the tremendous gifts that God has given us, and mindful of our duty to labor in the vineyard, we pray not for ourselves, but for the whole world, that all may respond generously to the call of the Father. For the shepherds of the church, that their faith-filled teaching and preaching will lead all God's people into the one sheepfold of grace, we pray to the Lord. That those secures justice and the rights of all the oppressed, and that during this Respect Life Month, we will work fervently to advance the gospel of life. We pray to the Lord. That our parish will be ever more devoted to Jesus and the Holy Eucharist. We pray to the Lord. That Christian families will be strengthened to face every challenge and difficulty as they grow in holiness. We pray to the Lord. For the grace this week to have greater faith in the Lord and his providence and readiness to do his will, we pray to the Lord. And for the intentions inscribed in our book of prayer, in our prayer baskets, and lifted to Jesus in the quiet of our heart, we pray to the Lord. For all of our beloved dead, especially Carl Schofer, we pray to the Lord. Heavenly Father, we, your beloved children, lift these prayers up to you through Christ our Lord. brethren, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father. Grant us, O merciful God, that this our offering may find acceptance with you, and that through it the wellspring of all blessing may be laid open before us, through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Father most holy, through your beloved Son, Jesus Christ, your Word, through whom you made all things, whom you sent as our Savior and Redeemer, and incarnate by the Holy Spirit and born the Virgin, fulfilling your will and gaining for you a holy people. He stretched out his hands as he endured his passion, so as to break the bonds of death and manifest the resurrection. And so with the angels and all the saints, we declare your glory, as with one voice we acclaim. Font of all holiness, make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, once more giving thanks, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." Mystery of faith. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and William, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Savior's command, and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always. And with your spirit. Let us offer each other the sign of peace. the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. this heavenly mystery, O Lord, restore us in mind and body, that we may be co-heirs in glory with Christ, to whose suffering we are united whenever we proclaim his death, who lives and reigns forever and ever. A special reminder to all of our parents of confirmation students, those who are in their freshman and sophomore year, we will be having our parent night tomorrow evening in the Family Center. Please do join us. We'll be going over our curriculum, which is U by Ascension Press, as well as what all of the expectations will be for our kiddos in our confirmation program for freshmen and sophomore. Please do keep our juniors in your prayers. They'll be confirmed at the beginning of November. That'll be a wonderful, wonderful thing. And next week, we look forward to having their retreat as well. So good things are indeed happening. Lots to pray for. As I was leaving the rectory today to come here, I heard some bumps in the night. So I think Father Todd is home. That or my cat has a new friend, one or the other. I haven't seen eyes, but I heard strange noises. So I'm sure he had a wonderful time, and he'll be happy to regale us of his great vacation over to the tremendous city of Sparta, Wisconsin. So, but it'll be it's a joy to have him back. Continue to share the good news of the Lord. Let us say yes to his love, yes to his invitation. Let's be mindful to be a Christian. It's not a spectator sport, but we got to follow. We got to do what we say we're going to do. We got to believe what the church teaches, and we have to share the love with everyone. So there's a lot of stuff we got to do, and may we continue to do so with that joy and zeal of the gospel. Don't forget, in just a couple of weeks, we have our pig roast too, so lots and lots of things are indeed happening. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Go in peace.